This is Bingo Bound, an old school Iron Man account who can only progress by completing randomly generated tasks on a bingo board. Bingo Bound will be completing everything from quests, diaries, and combat achievements, with the goal of eventually becoming a Grand Master.
Bingo.
Last time we left off finishing the bingo board with Doric's quest. Let's jump in right away with a new board. Okay, some good ones here. Demon Slayer instantly looking like something I want to do. Not sure I want to do 6 stash units right away or Eagle's Peak, and I can't kill a werewolf yet, so maybe not Demon's Quest right away. Mining an alchemy, that's easy. Hunter Shop is also easy. And Muddy Chest could be interesting. Not sure the drops there. Could get some useful stuff. Yeah, looking at the rest, let's go with that line. Let's get the Muddy Chest, Hunter Shop, Mining. So we will be tackling the easy stuff first. I'm going to just go and visit the Hunter Shop in Yanil, and then we're going to go over and mine some iron, do the easy stuff before getting a Muddy Key, which we'll be getting from Chaos Dwarves in the Wilderness. I was going to go to Tavalry Dungeon, but I think going through that entire dungeon for them is going to be a little bit troublesome, so I feel like going through and just going Thorns in the Wilderness using Ferox as like a bank will be a lot easier, and then we can just nip up and open up that chest. How do you do this? We never had anything. Let's see what I got. Does that not do it? It does! There we go, had it on clan mode. Magic dance. Oh, we completed an easy task in the Ardoin area. Perfect! Mining done. I'm going to stock up on some runes. The Muddy Key isn't too rare from the Chaos Dwarves, but I'm not sure how quickly I'll kill them. They haven't got any sort of weakness to air, so I'm not sure how fast I'll actually be able to take them down. And maybe 1,000 will be fine, but I'm going to stock up on a couple hundred more. We did get some extra money from the Steel Plate Bodies last episode, so not an issue at all with them. So I've got a little bit of a safe spot going on with these Chaos Dwarves here. There is one there as well, but I've had to trap this guy because he was able to come around and attack me. Now the drop rate for these is about a 1 in 18 for the Muddy Key itself. What I'm expecting from this chest, I'm not sure. All the rates are unknown. This content is very much not done. Probably people do it for this one little thing and then finish off from there. But you can actually get Laren's keys from these, so that's going to be fairly interesting. And Laren's key could be a big get. As you see, he's trapped, but I'm not sure how frequently I can get it. And that, of course, Laren's chests have such a wide range of items they can give you as well. So who knows what potentially I could get from this. It's likely going to be nothing, but the idea of getting a Laren's key excites me. Just as I missed the clip of getting level 40 magic, we have got our Muddy Key as well. A big moment. Muddy Key acquired. How much are these things worth these days? 7k. Wasn't too difficult. How many did I kill in total? 20, so a little over the drop rate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of these things. And they're a 1 in 21. And I got 6 in 20 kills. Okay, we are here. So I think this is the chest. We will just go ahead and open it, see what we get. Looks like we got the standard stuff from there. I am just gonna run away from this demon real quick, but it looks like we got the standard. So some chaos runes, mithril, a ruby, lore rune, death rune. Okay, so we have opened the Muddy Key, we have viewed the shop, and we have mined some iron. I did also check, this isn't a duplicate, but for some reason this is an easy and not medium, even though it's a medium task. Not sure why. Little thing, I've actually updated the code on this bingo board, so if I click this now, it should automatically increase and remove it from my old one. Yeah, there we go. Look at that. Automatic improvement. So I don't have to do any of that anymore. Perfect. That is so much better than having to go back into the task list itself and change it all manually. It does it all for me. And if I look at the completed task, you see I've had a little bit of a break. If you look from here to here, I have been traveling with work and I have been ill. So you can see there is actually a little bit of a break where I have not been playing. But we are back into it now. And let us hit the new board. Okay, talk to MM Trader. Really, really easy. Scariest novice. That's fun. Blue right limbs, we could do that, we could do that. That would be some Slayer, but we will need to increase in peril, so that is off the table. Bryophyta novice, also very good. That's easy as anything. I could do this, we could kill Bryophyta. Let me have a think and I'll come back to you in game. I have completed the task. I did defeat my main. Unfortunately, I did miss the actual thing. I pressed the wrong button on my keyboard to record, so that's always fun. But yeah, you went down, got the hard task completed, which is all done on here. There it is, Karamja hard task. We're just going to take a boat to Land's End now. First time we're stepping foot in Karen, so that's fun. And then we will roll the challenge wheel to see how we're going to make these blue right limbs. What kind of challenge awaits us? Okay, let's have a little gander here to Land's End. And there we go, complete an easy task in Corrent and Kevos. The first one in Corrent and Kevos we have completed. So I have messed up slightly. When I was initially doing this, I was like, okay, yeah, easy enough. Just get the challenge, do the blue right. It never occurred to me that the blue right, one, level 8, that's not hard enough. Level 8 would be fine. But after Knight Sword quest, I can't do Knight Sword yet just because I haven't received it as a task. So I shouldn't have ever have gone this line. What I'm going to do is I have taken the boat to Land's End and I've become the champion of the fight pit. What I'm going to do instead is go up the line from becoming the champion of the fight pit. I'm going to kill Bryophyta once and I'm going to talk to the emblem trader in Edgeville about emblems. Here we are looking at the absolute peak level 1 ranging performance here. We're going to train the entire thing on Moss Giants from level 1 onwards. It's not going to be fast to start, but I need every bit of prayer XP I can. I do want to go over prayer because it's going to take about 1500 kills of these to get level 37. But only about, on average, one in like 150, one in 160 to get the key. So we're going to have to go 10 times dry if we do want to get 37 from these. But what I'll do on my first key, whichever level I am, I'll get my best gear, my best arrows, and I will give my best shot at Bryophyta. If it doesn't go well, if I feel like I can't do it, I'll just keep trying every key. Every key will try and get that kill, essentially. A few kills later, and here we are, 20 ranged levels. We've killed 17 of these things, so it's going by quite quickly. We can have willow bows, and we can equip our studded body and our studded chaps. And I'm going to go back because I realize I haven't actually upgraded my bow for a while. I'm still using a short bow. So I've only just got like one hit in this guy, so I'm not going to finish it. I'm going to go back, get some more bronze arrows, and equip my new bow. And there we have it, 40 range. We can now wear green dragon hide, and that's what we will be doing. We still haven't got a mossy key. We are 148 in. We're almost on drop rate. There we go. Bingo Bound has reached range level 40. So just made my way to Narda to buy my gear. One dehide ram braces and one dehide chaps. This is going to help a lot. This is my first range gloves, so I'll plop them on right here. Matches the green, and this will give me a small bonus and a small magic defense bonus as well. The mossy key, the new collection log slot. Someone else in the chat had one the same time as me as well. But this does mean with these stats, we will go and fight Bryophyta for the first time. I'm gonna prep, I'm gonna grab some food together. 41 range, 24 defense, 23 prayer, so we can't even use Mystic Lore or Hawkeye. So we're now gonna make our way, sell some stuff to get some money together, and get some food, because the wine and the stews we have won't be enough. The food I'm taking with me is going to be pre-made gnome food. They heal 15 each and only cost 160 GP. Now I can buy Karambons, but they are twice the price, and as I'm expecting to have to try this a few times, I have to be a little bit cautious with my funds. For ammunition, I will be taking Mithril Arrows at my level with what praise I have available to me. Adamant doesn't actually grant me a max hit, so it's equal to Mithril but about 3 times the GP. In terms of poison, I'll be grabbing the super anti-poison doses from nearby the observatory. And with all that prep, let's take on the Moss Titan, Bryophyta.
Oh my god, 9 health. Oh my god, I did it. They hit me so many times. 9 health, oh my god. Who would have thought? Second kill, Bryophyta down. That was so unexpected. So unexpected. I got a second combat achievement for doing it well prepared. Didn't mean to do that. Honestly, didn't think I was going to get the kill. 9 health left, no food. Several hits in. Absolutely unbelievable. I hope you enjoyed the little montage I made just now as well. I've really had a lot of fun doing it. I'm having a lot of fun editing for this series. If you have got this far, please give a like, subscribe, do all that. I don't usually ask, but I feel like getting that Bryophyta kill earns me one of them. I'm just going to finish off the task here by talking to this emblem trader. That'll complete the line. And then we can roll a new board. Let's get into it. So we just talked to the emblem trader, and there it is, Bryophyta novice. Our epic battle concluded with the additional one of take a boat to Land's End, but we'll leave that in there. And let's roll this board and see what we're doing next here. Okay, a little tanning, death plateau, and biohazard. I haven't done Plague City yet, so I can't do that, can do that, but I can't do anything around it. Seal Cult, Sheep Shearer, and Sabot. I don't know where that is, if I have access. If I do, I'm just going to do that. That's really nice. If not, I can definitely do this. Let's have a look. I'll do a little digging. Time to do the Hazeel Cult. And with that, that is Hazeel Cult done. We gained some gold, 2,000 gold, a nice shiny icon, and level 21 thieving. Very nice stuff. Let us go to Brimhaven. Let's see how easy it's going to be with 20 agility to get a ticket from Brimhaven Agility Arena. I think they recently improved this, so even if I don't get there within a minute, as long as I tag two pillars, I should get there. So as long as I get the two pillars, I should be able to claim a ticket. It shouldn't be too difficult. Let me just get to the middle or get to a pillar soon. And I said, I'm not sure how difficult it's going to be with my agility level, but I guess we will see. It's all the way over there. I'm just going to get to the middle and we'll go from there. Okay, that's pillar one. You just get one straight away? Oh! You get one straight away. You don't even need to tag two anymore. Oh, there we go. And that is two collection log slots. You get the Agility Arena and the Brimhaven voucher. So while we're here, let's mark off this. We have claimed a ticket. And I have completed Hazeel Cult. Well, let's run the current challenge. What's it going to be? It's going to be Fog of War again. Perfect. We do like this one. It's going to be fun doing the Hunter in Fog of War. And I got to train the entire way up to a level 11 to be able to catch him. It is Cerulean Twitch. Perfect. We're back. The game in hours, boys. Here we are. Minimap our Fog of War on. So how I'm going to do this, I need to get to Yanil. And remember, we learned this trick with Fog of War. Whilst we're zoomed in like this, I can barely click in front of me. If I move up here, I can see a little bit. So that's how we're going to be playing. It's going to be a lot of fun. So I'm going to go, and there's no task from where I can see. I've searched it.
a few times throughout everything, looked on every diary I can. There's no task about catching a copper longtail. So I'm going to catch them up to level 11. Then I'm going to go up north, up to Ralka, to catch a cerulean twitch. Even with looking up now, I've changed the fog settings and it's so disorientating. Like, I can barely see myself when I zoom in. And even up here, I just missed your nil. I had to run back to it. It all looks so weird when you can't see exactly what's going on. I'm generally at the point where I'm a little bit lost. I think I'm by the hunting place now. But I have gotten lost like 3 times. I have no idea where I'm going. I'm trying to get to the coast. Oh, there. Oh, there we go. I got them. The Crimson Swifts. This is what I need, right? Birds, Crimson Swifts, jungle. Okay, I've got 2 bird snares. I believe I can only use 1 at a time. But this is going to be my life to level 11. I got lost for so long. Just missed a level 400 total coming in. This takes forever. I realize why I dislike early hunting, especially when I was a kid and I didn't know what I was doing. My word, this is taking a long time. So I took a quick break and I came back, logged in, and this is what I see. This is how insane the fog of war is when you're not expecting it. I don't even know where I am. Oh, there's my tree. And with this, we should be level 11. You can now trap cerulean twitches. I'll see you up there. Okay, I found the place. That took so long. It's honestly, it's taken me like 10 minutes to get here. That took forever. And as easy as that, I believe this is the task done. Catch cerulean twitch. Done. And new board on the way. Let's see what we've got. Anything interesting? Night sword. Really like night sword. Oh my god, there's so many good ones here. All of that's good. Oh wow. There's some really solid ones here. I can do pretty much every single one except for Mind Tiara, I think. I need some runecraft levels. Ernest the Chicken. Completed. And that is Murder Mystery complete. Let's see, how much crafting XP does that give me? Up to 16. I can create holy symbols, that's nice. Red topaz. An opal. Right, to craft a sapphire, I need to get 4 levels here. So, what is the best way for me to get this? I could craft some leather, which is probably what I'll do, to be honest, because killing cows will be easy enough. Could also spin some bowstrings. I may actually spin the bowstrings. I know it seems weird to do bowstrings with 4 levels, but I'll need to do fletching later, so might as well grab them. All the flax was picked. I picked them over at Land's End, because I can't do it in Seers, because it is a task. Luckily, not going to take too long. It's about 100 of them to do it, so there's the first level. Unholy symbols and stuff can be made, but this should be very quick. There's 3 more levels to go, and then I can go ahead with cutting a sapphire. Level 20 crafting. We can now cut sapphires. Got a few more flax left, but let us not do that for now. We'll go and cut this flax. I think I have a chisel on me. I'm not sure. I've never actually checked. Let me have a look here. So it's going here. Have I got a chisel? You know, it doesn't look like it. Let me go get a chisel real quick. And a 1 and a 2. And we have cut a sapphire. That is the task. All complete. Let's roll another board. Murder mystery complete. Ernest chicken complete. Cut the sapphire completed. Roll the board. What have we got to work with next? We can complete a lap of the Draenor village rooftop course. That's great. Priest in peril. Yes. Okay. Priest in peril is a hunt. Oh, no, I can't do that. Oh no. Oh. Can I? 1 sec. This potential. Unlock the crystal chest. I'm gonna look how to get a key. If there's ways I can get this key, because I really want Priest in Peril done. It unlocks all of the Mauritania steps. Alfred's bar crawl. I'm gonna look into it. I really need to do this line. I can't do this one. I can't teleport there yet. I need to do this line, man. So badly. So I did have a look, and the crystal key is just going to be way too random to get. It's one of those items that, unless you have access to the higher end stuff, barrows for example, you can get it from the gnome restaurants, you can get it from that minigame. There's just no reliable way of me getting it. I could be here for hundreds of hours, I'm not sure, aiming to get that one thing. So I'm going to do the other line. I'm going to go and complete a lap of a Draenor agility course. I'm going to get a haircut done, and I'm going to mine 5 clay. And I think that will be that line complete. Priest and Peril will come up again. Just a shame we couldn't get it this time. There we go. Draenor village rooftop lap count is 1. Let's go up to Faldor now and get that haircut. And then we will go back down to the desert and mine a couple of bits of clay and roll again. There we go. Easy task complete. And that's clay number 5. Let's get ourselves another board rolled. Okay, so we mined 5 clay in the desert. We did get a haircut. Of course, we completed a lap of the rooftop course in Draenor. And look at that, past 25%. Now the color has changed. We're now in orange territory. Let's hit that new board. See what we get. Okay, some good stuff here. Agent Hands. Honestly, there's a few things that look good. Planting a jute seed, poor side of interest, that kind of thing. As usual, I'll think and I'll meet you back in game. So I need to start farming. So I thought the best way of doing it is to get some super compost. It's really nice early on. You can essentially get a lot more farming XP than if you could before. So I'm going to go ahead and fill as many as it up. I've been collecting pineapples from Karamja, just running back and forth and collecting them. And I will fill up each of these things. I'll go here. Probably the one in Catherby and the one just north of Ardyne as well. Can't stop me now. Easy task completed. Swing to the Moss Giant Island.
You gotta give him that hawk to and spit on that thing, you get me?
I don't think we'll take the Slayer task, because that is poor sign of interest. Completed. Level 9. Perfect. Getting those total levels up there now. Only a few we haven't touched now with that. We haven't done any smithing, fletching, runecraft, or construction. But everything else we've touched in the game, which is kind of nice. And that is 2 of the tasks done. It is just jute now. So I do have to wait around for that. Well, looks like the super compost is done. Let's gather this bad boy up. Get that sweet, sweet farming XP. And with that, we can now plant jute seeds. We have them already on us. I'm going to finish off these potatoes. Head on over to the patch. Plant up the jute seeds and we can roll again. I don't believe I need to actually harvest them. It's just planting, so that's pretty good. Okay, I should just get from planting this. There we go, the easy task has been complete. Okay, so what have we done? We have just planted the seeds. We have done a poor sign of interest. And we used the rope swing to travel to the Moss Giants. Let's hit that new board and see what we get. Restless Ghost is good. That was the Warren's General Store. I think that requires a quest, I'm not sure though. 5 seaweeds easy. Catch a mackerel. I believe I can already do that and have a apothecary make you a strength potion. I'm gonna have a little research, see what I can't do. Get into this in a second. Okay, it looks like we can do everything. Browsing the Warren's General Store doesn't have a prerequisite like I thought it did. So we can go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna do that. Restless Ghost and collecting 5 seaweed. I think that is gonna be the quick 3-piece out of the way. Makes more sense for the line. So I'm gonna do Restless Ghost first and collect 5 seaweed. Then we do have to roll the challenge board. So let's start Restless Ghost. I'll see you when I'm done. Restless Ghost completed. A bit of prayer XP. And of course, Ghost Speak Amulet. We can now use Hawkeye. Wouldn't have that been good for Bryophyta. I just realized something big. That is 32 quest points. That actually unlocks the Champions Guild for us. and unlocks champion scrolls for us. So that was quite a large quest, which I kind of skipped past. I didn't even realize we were getting there. As is tradition, you can, of course, just pick it up over and over. There's no need to collect separate ones. There's the easy task completed. And now we'll roll the bingo to see what kind of challenge we get. Okay, I have to imagine it's this guy. Yeah, got that. You know, I was wondering, hold on here as well, what the hell? You gotta wonder how bad this fog of war is gonna be when I go to Valamore, because I don't know that area at all, really, apart from like this kind of the Hunter's Guild. Because even this place, which I've come down a few times as I've done the quests, I got lost. I was like over here. I was like looking at this fishmonger going, is it you? I'm not. So I don't know. It's Valamore with a fog of war is going to be deadly for me. But that was all three done. I think I'll roll one more board for this episode. So let's have a look here. Chop that off. New board. What have we got? Priest in power, please. Okay, can't do this yet. We are starting to get really hemmed in by Mauritania, because if you look at this, both of them are Mauritania. But the rest of these we can kind of do. Enter the Troll Stronghold. I think we need Death Plateau. I'll have a look. If we can, then we can do this. Then we can do this. We can do this. So we actually have to do a bit of construction training. I didn't realize that the two family crest, to get the family crest identified by Serenity, we actually need to have 16 construction. Let's find out. Are we gonna need another sword? There's a chance. There is a chance. Come on. A long sword. Okay. Perfect. We didn't need to do another one. It's only an iron sword, but I'm glad we didn't need to go and grab another one there. There is a chance it gives you nothing and you have to do something else to complete this task. So that's one done. I'm going to nip up to Seer's Village, grab the 5 flax, and then we can get our construction training on the way. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. We can now pick flax permanently from here without having to go back to Land's End. We'll make bowstrings a lot easier to get in the future. I'm going to head over to a rock, get myself a house. A little bit of a big moment here, so I've just been gathering some planks together from 2 plank spawns here, but I realize there's no task that stopped me from using teleport to house, so I'm actually going to teleport outside of Rimmington. That's the first time we've been able to use our magic level to actually teleport, which is kind of great, to be honest, and I don't believe there's anything stopping me from actually entering here, so let's jump in there. Here's our little house. Level 16, I believe that is the level we need now. And here is Serenity. Let me have a look here. What can you do for me? Chat. Can you see if I have a family crest? And bingo bound. Barak, no problem at all. Easy task, and that is another Faldor one done. But of course, I hope you have enjoyed the episode. It's been quite a fun one. We've got quite a lot done. If you got this far, please leave a like, comment, subscribe, do all that good stuff. And I'll see you next time, everyone.